Hello, everybody. Rob Cootie here, the MLM Solution. How you doing today? It's September the 13th, and it's currently 10:57 and 3 seconds Eastern Standard Time. As you know, we go live each and every day, Monday through Friday, at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. As you can see on the ticker, but if you've been following us for a while, you already know that. On our YouTube channel and our Facebook page, if you want to find us on either one of those platforms or any platform for that matter, just use our hashtag, which is hashtag the MLM Solution. Once again, hashtag the MLM Solution. You can go to our website and click on the live podcast link there, and you'll be able to watch it from the website as well. TheMLMSolution.net, TheMLMSolution.net. If you will, share, hit the share button while you're there, and let our fellow network marketers all across the globe have access to this wonderful information, products, et cetera, so that they too can be empowered to do great things with this wonderful business model. Point being, you can have a positive impact on somebody you don't even know across the globe by simply sharing. It takes 1 to 2 seconds to do that. And we will say thank you in advance. All right. With that being said, today's topic number 250, why you need to build from one live event to another. Podcast number 250, why you need to build from one live event to another. We're going to tell you why that is a standard in the business building process, has been for a long time. We're going to tell you the power of that. We're going to tell you what will happen if you don't use it, etc. So join us today at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on our Facebook page and our YouTube channel. With that being said, I'm going to hop off here before it's too late. I'll see you.
Welcome to the MLM Solution Podcast Show, where you'll learn the facts and hear the truth about the network marketing industry. Here's your host, Rob Cootie and Marie Cannon.
Hello, Miss Marie. How are you doing today?
Hello there. Happy Monday to you.
Happy Monday.
How's it going?
It's going very well, thank you. Busy, busy, busy.
Well, as you know, I know you are too. I feel like the weekend just like flew by. I was so busy. It was like from sunup to sundown and even beyond that.
Oh,
it's just
man.
Like, whew, I need a break from the break.
I can't believe it's the 13th already. It seems like you and I were just celebrating a holiday weekend. You know, Labor Day. Oh my gosh. And here it is the 13th already.
Yep. Here we go again.
Here we
almost
go again.
Halfway through the month already.
I told the wife, I said, what is the holiday plans? Because every year, it's been the same for years, but because of the virus, blah, 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 things change. So I said, what's the schedule for this year? I've asked her like 2 or 3 times to make sure it's not going to change, but also to make sure that I have our bases covered as far as the show goes. I got to make sure that we get all the holiday shoppers, Christmas shopping done, because you never know what's going to happen in the next 3 months in regards to economy and all that. So I'm trying to plan ahead. and you might, a lot of people say it's only September. I know, but there's a big but there.
Yeah, before you know it.
Yes, with the show and everything else that you and I have going on, December will be on me in no time. I mean, we're halfway through September.
Uh-huh.
It's unbelievable.
I know.
And to me, October starts the holiday season. What I mean is the weather starts to get a little bit cooler. It's in the air. You know, and then Halloween really starts kicking things off around our household. I can't speak for anybody else. From that point on, Miss Marie, till January 5th or 6th, we are in a blur because we spend a lot of time with our family and we're doing this, we're doing that. I mean, we're running around. And when you got a big family, you know, Christmas shopping becomes a chore. And so you got to squeeze it in there with everybody else, you know, I mean, with everything else, excuse me.
Yep.
So you get it. You understand.
I do.
Mm-hmm. So with that being said, Miss Marie, today is Monday, the 13th. And our topic for today, and it's number 250. I was going to put up a celebratory video for number 250 and surprise you. But you know what? I did not get home in time. I just got home minutes before the show. And so it was hard for me to do that. I should have done it this weekend, but I was so busy, like everybody else, like you.
Well,
no excuse.
You've got to be planning for the episode 300 because you've been trumpeting that one for.
I know. I'm excited
plus,
about that.
50 plus episodes now, so I'm
special
for 300. So that one you better deliver.
There you go. And you know what? 250 is a milestone. Let's be honest. 150 episodes, Miss Mary, is a lot, and that's awesome. And tickle pink, and you've made it very pleasurable. So thank you. You have been a godsend, and I'm really grateful that you're here.
Well, I'm glad I can help. I enjoy being here, and I hope all of our listeners, our viewers, are getting a lot of value out of this, whether you've been with us since episode number one, or you just joined us for today's episode. You know, we do our best to bring value, to bring information that will help you achieve the level of success you mm-hmm. want in terms of your income, your time freedom, elevating your lifestyle if that is what you are after. So
that's right.
All the good stuff, none of the nonsense that you get some other places. And we do talk about the good, the bad, and the ugly, right? We don't sugarcoat things. We're not all happy, happy, joy, joy, which, you know, I love people that can do that, but that's certainly not me.
No. I agree. You and I are cut from the same cloth, and I'm glad you like that. Because, look, everything in life is not rosy. And I think when people paint a picture like that, Miss Marie, it immediately tells me my antennas go up. Red flags go up because I know that everything has a yin and a yang. And if they're only talking about all yin, all positive, in other words, they're covering up for the yang. And you know what? Sometimes the yang could be bigger than the yin. In other words, the problem could be bigger than any benefit you could get from doing what you're going to do. So Miss Marie's absolutely right. We talk about the good, the bad, and the ugly. Because look, you have a right to know the challenges that come with this business. And there's no shame in that. It is what it is. It's life. And, you know, you either pull your pants up and get on with it, or you're going to sit and suck your thumb. I mean, Miss Marie and I don't care which one you do. We're an advocate for the industry, and we love people. But we understand our goal, as you know, Miss Marie, we never have said our goal is to make every person happy. Because we know that you and I in this show is a dividing rod. You either believe us or you don't. And that's okay. That's cool. Right.
And we know we can't make everybody happy. No. We're not pizza.
No, that's right. Good point. I like that. Yeah, no, absolutely, guys. No disrespect to anyone. Okay. Everybody's got a different approach. Everybody's got a different viewpoint. Everybody's got a different opinion. That's good. We're happy with that. We are not here. We're just teaching the basics. And all you got to do is look at our whole body of work. Wouldn't you agree, Miss Marie? Go back, and I challenge you to find anything that's not based in the basics. We do not venture off the path of basics, because if we do, we're putting ourselves in trouble. We're putting our reputations in jeopardy, and we're also promoting something that we're not sure is going to work. We have run into a lot of things. you know, Ms. Marie, I don't know about you, but sometimes I'm real stupid. The answer is staring me right in the face, and I'll make this big circle. Before I come back to where I started. Not all the time, you know.
Because sometimes it just seems too obvious. It can't be that easy, right?
It is.
Make things more complicated than we need to. Yeah.
And you know what else is a fallacy with me? Can't speak for anybody else. I've always been taught to keep an open mind, and I agree with that, okay? And an open mind means, well, there might be a better way. There might be a more efficient way, and that starts it. You know, but sometimes I go, whoop, I just smirkle. The circle's real small because I'm like, oh, no, hell no, I ain't doing that. Whoop, you know, get right back to the basics. Sometimes out of my own, I am not going to point fingers at anybody else. It's my own mind. But I do. I do believe keeping an open mind. I do believe in trying other things and giving it a shot. You know that. You've seen a little bit of that. And you know what? It always comes back to where it should have been from the beginning for me.
Exactly.
For me. Yeah.
No, I'm with you. And I'm excited about the topic we have today. But before we go there, you know, you mentioned checking out our body of work. If people don't know where to do that, they can visit any of our social media platforms. Mm-hmm. You can find those by using hashtag the MLM solution. That's hashtag the MLM solution. Or visit our website, themlmsolution.net. All sorts of products out there. And one of the big things we've got there is a link to register for our upcoming live event. And it's a notification link at this point. All you're doing is pre-registering, drop your information in there, take you all of a minute and a half to fill out that form. That's simply so we can communicate with you as we narrow down and make plans and iron out the details for what will be our first live event.
Yes.
So you can catch that on our website, themlmsolution.net, or you can go directly to MLMMastersAcademy.com.
That's right.
That's our registration link there, MLMMastersAcademy.com. And extra special for the first 100 people who do register on that site and then actually attend the live event once that rolls around, we've got some special VIP treatment for you. So make sure you go fill it out. Nothing tied to it right now. You won't have any salesy emails. You're not charged anything. This is simply a notification registration at this point in time. So we can fill you in, and we're working on it. It's coming.
Yes, and I'm very excited about it. I was thinking about it a lot this past weekend, and I'm very excited about it. And you know, I have this this saying. Let me pull this down real quick. And I'll pull this. Hopefully, I don't tear it up. And this is not about self. I know we're getting a little off topic today, but I'll get right back on it. Three simple rules in life. If you do not go after what you want, you'll never have it. If you don't ask, the answers will always be no. If you do not step forward, this is one I like, you will always be in the same place. And when it scares the crap out of you to step forward, I don't know if we can afford to do that. I don't know if we have the tools to make that happen. Those are excuses. You just got to bulldoze through it. You just like to, what's that show with the two women driving off the cliff?
Thelma and Louise.
One of my favorite shows. So many twists and turns in that. So many truths in that. It's not even funny. Anyway, the point is, what did they do? As sad as it is to say, they held hands and they stepped on the gas.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't mean just going over the cliff. I mean, during the whole thing, you know. What'd they do? Every time they got in trouble, every time they ran, what'd they do? They got in a car, put it in drive, and took off, right?
Yeah. Well, here's what I like about that number three. It's take a step forward, right? Just a step.
That's it.
You don't have to have the whole path mapped out.
There it is.
You don't have to have the direct line to where you want to get. You just have to take the next step. And it's one of the things I harp on here all the time is, you know, we can give you all the information and education you could possibly want. But unless you're going to take action, it's not going to do anything.
There it is.
See? So take that next step and get moving.
There it is. You got to step forward. Just like standing in line, somebody says, I need a volunteer. You know, you don't know what you're volunteering for. That's kind of a bad example, but you get my point. But that's what I'm talking about. When they put it in drive and stepping on the gas pedal, what were they doing? They were stepping forward. They were leaving behind whatever it is they encountered, whether it was good or bad. And they went on to the next step. And, I could use a better example, I'm sure, but you get the point. A lot of people are familiar with that movie. That's the reason why I brought it up. And that's what that number three reminds me of. It's exactly what you're saying. You know, step on the gas pedal and let's go. And you know what? You'll figure it out as you go along, right?
Absolutely.
And that's what you and I have been doing. We have been working hard and diligently moving forward with a lot of things here. And we are continuing to do that, guys. We are putting one foot in front of the other. Sometimes it's as slow as a snail, and other times it's as fast as a rabbit. But we are always moving forward. All right, with that being said, today's topic, Miss Marie, as like you said, is one of that I look forward to talking about, because this is one of the cornerstone business building tactics that you never hear about. Now, if you're listening, you're saying, wow, what are you talking about? Guys, this tactic's been around for a long time. And you say, well, what is it? Miss Marie and I have done episodes on live events. And if you don't remember that, or, you know, because you did listen to it and you don't remember the content or you never listened to it, just go to our Facebook page or YouTube channel and put in live events. listen to those episodes, because that is essential to understanding why live events themselves are so powerful. Okay. There's nothing that can replicate people being in front of people. The synergy, the excitement, everything that comes with that cannot be replicated any other way. I don't care about telephone conference calls. I don't care about Zoom calls. I think Zoom calls are far better than conference calls, although conference calls still have their place, all right? And here's the thing, Miss Marie. If you do a conference call, there is a certain amount of excitement of knowing and hearing that there's 1,000 people on the call, right? Mm-hmm. We've experienced that on both ends. At the same time, Zoom calls, having hundreds of people, whether it's YouTube, where you can do YouTube Live, whether you're doing it on Zoom, whether you're doing it through a webinar, all of these platforms have certain limitations, some only 250, some 1,000. But the point is, there's a certain amount of excitement when people get on and go, oh my gosh, look at all the people that are here. But there's nothing like being there in person, period. Okay. Now, the smart business builders way back when saw that. They figured it out because, look, a lot of these business builders are very smart, intelligent, and insightful people. And you say, well, why do you say that? Well, it's not because of their business knowledge and experience. It's what they did with that knowledge and experience when they combined it with human behavior. They were smart enough to understand that people can be motivated when they're around like-minded people in large groups, right, Ms. Marie? Mm-hmm. Whether it's a football game, baseball game, high school football game, high school basketball, it doesn't matter. If the gym was full, there's a certain amount of excitement, right, Ms. Marie, versus a gym, even at the high school level, there's only 18 people in it.
Absolutely. Okay? Yep.
So the thing is, there's this natural thing when an athlete comes out of the locker room onto a football field, baseball field, or in a basketball court, and they see a full stadium. Okay, even if they're not from that area, even if their parents or friends are not there, the fact that they say, wow, look at all these people that came to watch us play. And then your juices start flowing, you get hyped up, and you are fired up. And a lot of times you play above your skill level. So what do you think happens at live events? Now, I tell you that because since they cannot be replicated, there's nothing you can do as a leader to ever replicate a live event. And you say, well, what about if you have your own? It doesn't matter whether it's got your name attached to it, Miss Marie's, or Ding Dong Down the Street, or SpongeBob. Okay, it doesn't matter. A live event is a live event is a live event. It doesn't matter who's the host and who's putting it on. That's irrelevant. What's relevant is the number of people, the excitement, the buzz. When people walk in, Miss Marie and Roy's talking, you know the buzz that's in the air. All the voices mending together, and you can't make out the individual conversations, but you're excited because you hear people talking and people are having a good time. You say, wow, this is really cool. That being said, guys, even if you're doing a local one, don't ever underestimate a local event that has 8 to 15, maybe 50 people in it. There is synergy that comes with that, right, Ms. Marie?
Yeah.
You can't beat that. And then when you go to a regional event, then you start having hundreds, sometimes a couple thousand, 3,000 people at regional events. You get to the national events, and a lot of times they sell out basketball arenas. Have you ever been to those?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, and football arenas. I've been to those. So the thing is that you have a situation where you are going to be a part of something that if you build from one to the other, that you cannot build yourself. Because when you go to the regional and national level, Ms. Marie, it's not just your business. A lot of times, even at a regional event, if you're all using the same business building system, which we talked about, if everybody's using the five simple steps and Ms. Marie is in Ohio and I'm in Kentucky, and we know each other and said, hey, let's hold an event, I don't know where, somewhere in southern Ohio. And since we both use the same business building system, we'll just bring all the people together. So instead of me having 500 people at my event here in Kentucky, I say to her, yeah, let's do that. And she has 1,000 people. Together, we have 1,500 people. And the buzz and excitement and the travel, it's all different. It's all new. And people are excited, especially if new people looking at the business for the first time. They come in and they see 1,500 people, and they're like, oh, my gosh, I'm missing out. Look at the size of this thing. Okay? They are excited. Okay? You, once again, cannot replicate that on your own. Okay, now I laid out the scenario. Why is this important? Because you cannot create the excitement, the buzz, the electricity in the air and all the things that come with it. And once again, listen to the live event, other podcasts, and you'll get greater detail about these live events. Because you can't replicate that, and because there's a certain amount of synergy and excitement that takes place in these things, and the new people that you invite, and they get there, they go, oh my gosh, I saw all these people go across stage, and they sounded and looked like me. They started out with nothing, and now they've got this. I saw them get a new pin ring. I saw the life they have now. I got to talk to them. I got to shake their hand. This is real to me. These people are actually making this work. I want to do this. You don't even have to recruit. All you got to do is get people to on live events, right, Miss Marie? That's what we're talking about. Build from one event to the other. Guys, I don't care if you're having a bi-weekly local event. Let's say I was doing one here in Louisville, Kentucky, and every two weeks I'm doing a live event. And I start out and only have four people. It takes me 2 or 3 months, and all of a sudden I got 10 or 15 people. And then 3 or 4 months down the road, I got 50 or 60 people, right, Miss Marie? Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, your local event may never get bigger than 50, 60 people. Why? Because you're spreading out. You don't want to stay local. You want to sponsor as many people across the United States and the world as you can, right, Ms. Marie? Especially if you know the company's going into Israel in 6 months, okay, or some other Asian country in 8 months. You better be sponsoring a lot of people locally that have connections in Israel and wherever. Or you need to be sponsoring them yourself, somehow making headway into those countries yourself. Why do I say that? Because your numbers at the local level may kind of stay the same for a while, right, Miss Marie? Because your goal is not to own the local area. Your goal is to mine the local talent that has connections across the world, right, Miss Marie? That's what you're looking for, okay? And when people sign up with you, when people say, Rob, I want to work with you, you say, okay, guess what? Do you know anybody in Israel? Why do you ask that, Rob? You don't say it when you're recruiting them. You just tell them, you know anybody in Israel? Well, why do you say that? I do. I have a few friends there because we're going in Israel in 6 months. Really? Yes. And if you want, we will get on the phone and we will work with those guys. We'll do a presentation with them right away. And let them know what's going on. We talked about the pre-launch, right? So go and look at the pre-launch. We're not going to get into that here. That's a powerful one to talk. Well, both of them, the live event podcast and the pre-launch, whether it's a product or whether it's going to another country is irrelevant. Guys, listen to those podcasts. They are some of the most powerful ones we have ever done. Would you not agree?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. There's great information there. And the other thing I want to add on to your, you can't just entirely focus local anymore because we have very much of a global economy, right? Yeah. And the technology is such that it supports the ability to tap into your network of people across the country, if not around the world.
That's right.
And you absolutely want to leverage those contacts that you have. And that's not always going to be just local and live.
That's right.
And as we've learned over the past year and a half, almost 2 years now, sometimes there are circumstances in the world that prevent us from doing things in person.
Yes.
And we need to leverage the technology even more, which actually beneficial expands your reach.
Yeah, yeah. And so what you want to do, guys, like she said, you want to be able to focus on what? Getting as wide as you can across the world and building from one event to the other. Okay, and you always want to be pushing forward towards what? As I said, if I'm doing local events every 2 weeks, what am I doing? I'm inviting new people, and I'm encouraging my current partners to what? Bring new people themselves. Now, if every one of my local people bring one person, I got to work my tail end off to get two people there. I don't want my downline showing me up. I got to show them that I'm working harder than they are or something so that they say, well, Rob did two. I need to do two. Okay. And we'll do a story on that later. But the point is, the reason I bring that up, I have one every 2 weeks. That means every 2 weeks, I want to bring what? New people to those events. And I want to encourage what? My downline to what? Bring new people. Now, the thing is that your leaders will stand up because your leaders will bring new people every 2 weeks. Okay. The other people do it 2 or 3 times and start fading off. Got to realize this business is about a dividing. It is dividing the pretenders from the contenders, right, Miss Marie? That's all it is. You're going to have some people are going to step up and some that don't. Now, I'm not going to go down this path because that's another story for another day. But I'm telling you that because it's a little golden nugget insight. Don't get caught up. Build from every 2 weeks. Rob's building on a local level every 2 weeks, and I'm always going to be inviting new people because I want to build and I want to invite them where they see other people there. I want to leverage that synergy, that excitement, and let them see there's other people locally that are a part of this movement. Right, Miss Marie? Mm-hmm. And then if we have a regional one, as I said, Miss Marie's in Ohio, I'm in Kentucky, we decide to come together and hold one in lower southern Ohio. And what am I going to do? Every 3 months, Miss Marie and I are going to say, you know what, Rob, we're the only big shots out here in this part of the country. We ought to have these regional events once every 3 months. Right, Miss Marie? Mm-hmm. And you say, why? Well, if you haven't listened to ours, this business works in thirds. We talk about that all the time. And this is not about the one-third, one-third, one-third. That's totally different. This business works in thirds. So why do you do it every 3 months? Number one, human beings, by the 90th day, start, they're excited, and then they start leveling off. Life gets in the way. Next thing you know, their momentum, their excitement, and they get worn down. Right, Miss Marie? So every 3 months, what do? You plug them into the wall, and you recharge them, right, where they're all excited and ready to go again. How do you do that? With a regional event. See, Ms. Marie and I understand human behavior. We're combining that human behavior with what? If we're smart, with business building activity, right, Ms. Marie? Yep. Called a regional event. So what do we encourage our local people to do? Our leaders in our downline that are stepping up, we said, guys, build from one regional event to the other. If you're local and you're doing one every 2 weeks, which you should be local, Ms. Marie, because you can't do it every month, you'll lose momentum. You can't have one every month. If you start getting really big, where you start having 30, 40, 50 people every couple of weeks, you need to go to every week, right, Ms. Marie? You cannot slow down. You have to scale it up, not scale it down, right? The numbers that attend are what tells you, okay, what you need to do. All right. So that being said, you build what? Towards the regional events. You'd use the local events as often as necessary, which is going to, you should start out with at least one every 2 weeks. Hopefully you start building it up to where you're doing two every 2 weeks, and then you might end up doing one every week. If you're on the go and you're really rocking this thing, it's not just you bringing new people in locally, it's your downline too, your local downline. Guess what? Eventually you'll make it to that level. Now here's the thing. All of that activity builds up to what? The next level, which is once every 3 months, a regional event that Miss Marie and Rob are hosting. We get a venue in Southern Ohio that's big enough to hold 2,000-3,000 people, and we're bringing in 1,500 people every 3 months. Okay. And hopefully we're doing our job right. The next one, 3 months later, we'll have 1,800 people instead of 1,500. Okay. And then we'll have to find a larger venue if it only hosts 2,000 people. Okay. Now, you say, why is this important? Because once again, the synergy, the excitement that is created in a large environment like that is you cannot duplicate that. What you have to do is be smart and tap into what is being placed at your doorstep. I'm telling you, if you try to build this business on your own without the excitement and the synergy that's being created, then you are going to fail because you as an individual cannot carry that. I have tried. And it's not on purpose. It's because in some companies, Miss Marie, I did not have those regional opportunities. All I had was the national, which was once a year. It is next to impossible to build a business where you have one national event once a year. Because people don't see that far out. This excitement and the momentum, I couldn't carry it. You know what I'm saying? I'm not Superman, you know?
Well, exactly. And there's different types of events that you can like leverage as well. What's that?
I like your shirt.
Oh, the I'd rather be napping.
Don't know, I'd rather be napping.
I was out too late last night. It felt appropriate.
There you go.
But I was going to say you're building towards different types of events as well, because you have events that you're creating or have created for you within your sales organization. And then you have events that are created through the network marketing company as well, right? So when we talk about building from event to event, it's the local events. You're building one to another, building that excitement within the local events. You're building towards regionals and you're getting people excited about those, which again, each step up is more people, more synergy, more social proof, more excitement that goes on just because of the sheer numbers and the energy that that amount of people in one place brings, right? And then typically you'll have your network marketing companies that will do a national or international type of convention once a year, maybe twice a year. Some network marketing companies will even put on regional events if they have organizations enough numbers to support it in various places. So whatever live events you have available to you, you want to leverage to build your organization, to build your leaders, to help your leaders build their teams, and you're building towards each one. And it may be you're actually at a regional event and the next event coming up is a local event. Well, you're going from larger to a little bit smaller. But again, it's an in-person event. It's an opportunity to bring people in and build that dynamic. So no matter which way you're going in terms of scaling local, regional, national, or vice versa, you do want to build from event to event, whatever that next live event is, to get people plugged in and excited and relight that fire. You know, people come in, they get started in the business and they're all excited about it. And it's like a campfire, right? If you don't add more wood to the fire or stay near the fire, it starts going down and it cools off. It's not as warm anymore.
That's right.
These events it's throwing more fuel on the fire and getting everybody lit up and heated up again and excited and going for a period of time.
That's right.
Yeah.
And just to let you guys know, she's absolutely right. Absolutely. Thank you. You nailed it. Corporations sometimes will hold an event, a national event, once every 6 months. Some companies will do it once a year. Hopefully you guys will have one that'll do it once every 6 months. Okay. Now, here's the thing. You want as many new people, because she's right. That fire is a perfect example. Here, and let me give you an even deeper insight using the fire. If you're sitting by a campfire and you take a good size branch out, okay, let's say the size of a stick, a good size stick, you know, about this big around, and you take it out of the fire and it's burning pretty good and you set it off to the side and you got it propped up. You don't lay it in the dirt. You got it propped up sideways. It'll burn for a little bit, but within a minute or two, the flame will be gone. And all you'll have is a glowing stick, and within hours, it'll be just a smoldering stick. Why? Well, because it wasn't with the other sticks in the fire. Okay. My point in that example is this. If you try to build this without going to a regional event, a national event, guess what? You are that stick. You'll burn bright for a while. But if you try to do this on your own, you don't have the power and strength on your own to maintain that intensity, right? That's where you keep that thing burning. It's just not possible, guys. You've got to build from one event to the other, okay? Now, the only way that you can keep this thing going is exactly what she just said. You've got to add more wood to the fire, meaning more new people. You always want to go to a regional event with as many new people as possible. If you could have 30 of your downline and 60 new people, you are a winner. You are on your way. If you can always bring more new people than you bring downline, and you say, well, Rob, what does that mean? What I'm saying as far as my downline, let's say I have 5,000 people in my downline. Let me clarify the point. And let's say out of those 5,000 people, I have 15 leaders to help me build that group of 5,000 people. I'm worried about those 15 people. I'm going to invite everybody, all 5,000. I'm going to put out a message, right, Miss Marie, and say, bring new people. I know the numbers and how it's going to work. It's going to be pretty much 80-20, right, Ms. Marine? Mm-hmm. Okay, so 20% of 5,000 people is going to seriously consider it, okay? How many out of that 1,000 people is going to end up coming? I don't know, okay? It could be the 80-20 all over again. It could be 75-25. I don't know, but here's the point. I pretty much know what I'm going to be dealing with. But the one thing I can count on is the 15 leaders who are taking this serious, because they are the ones that rose to the top and helped me build this organization of 5,000 people. And here's the thing. They will be there and they will have new people because they get it. They understand these are the new logs they're going to lay on the fire. Right, Miss Marie? Mm-hmm. They are going to be there. So how many new people do I have? I don't worry about my 15 people. I don't count them because I know they're going to be there. What I'm counting and excited about is what, Miss Marie? The people, the new people that are taking a look at this business. They didn't even join yet. I'm excited. Or somebody that just joined the day before the regional event. Right, Miss Marie? Those are the people that count. I don't care about the people that they're, this is their 19th regional event. Okay. If they haven't done anything in 19 regional events, they're not going to do anything. Some people will attend just for the fun of it. That's cool. Miss Marie and I have talked about that, and we truly embrace them, don't we, Miss Marie?
Yep.
We don't have one bad thing to say about those people. We love everybody. And I kid you not, it's not a play on words. Here's the thing. We know the importance of having new people there. Understand that recruiting or new people, whatever you want to call it, is the lifeblood of this business. You have to constantly have new people coming in. And not just you, not just Rob, not just Miss Marie, but your downline as well. Right, Miss Marie? You want to ensure your own future? Bring new people yourself. Don't sit and say, well, I've got 15 people. They'll bring new people. And you show up with nobody. What do you think that message is going to put out to your leaders? You know, when you retire, and when you finally make the income and lifestyle level that you want, and you make it public to your 5,000 people and your leaders, guys, I finally made it. I'm finally here. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I couldn't have done this alone. It's all because of you guys. I'm going to retire, but I'm still going to be here to help you guys. I'm no longer going to recruit. That's the only time, Ms. Marie, you have an excuse, legitimate excuse, not to bring new people. Would you not agree?
Yes.
Okay. Otherwise, you better bring new people, right? Because if you don't, you are setting a terrible example. New people, new people, new people. Always build from one event to the other. Bring in what? New people. Why? Because the synergy, the electricity in the air, cannot be replicated in any other way. Have I made that clear, Miss Marie? Is that a good summarization?
I think that's a great summarization. And yeah, I totally agree. Don't know that I could have said it any better myself.
Well, but we didn't leave any important stuff out, right?
Try not to.
No, but I didn't there, correct? I mean, that's correct. What you do. The purpose of the live events is to bring new people.
Yep.
As many as you can. And once you get those new people going over the next 3 months before the next regional event, what do? You encourage your new people to bring new people, right? And you just keep doing it over and over and over. And guess what? Your tried and true 15 leaders will continue to bring new people themselves and encourage their downline. That's what makes up the 1,800 people that attend the regional events. And you really, if you're the leader, if Miss Marie and I are holding this event, our goal and our hope would be out of 1,800 people, that 1,100 of them would be new people. That's a sign of a healthy business, right, Miss Marie?
Well, that's definitely the sign of a growing business that's on its way upwards. That's right. It's on an upward
healthy
trajectory.
Because the system's working,
yep.
It's producing results, and the people get it, and they're saying, I can get behind this because it's producing the results I want. And guys, always remember as we close, this business is about lifestyle, period. The money that you make supports the lifestyle you want. This business is all about lifestyle, whether it's the personal freedom you want, financial freedom, to be able to travel. Miss Marie, it all boils down to lifestyle. Because the lifestyle, in order to live the lifestyle, you got to have the money, right?
Right.
And in order to have personal freedom, you got to have the lifestyle, right?
Exactly.
If you're personally free and you have no job because you can support yourself with your business, guess what? You're on your way to having a great life. And that is an incredible lifestyle. Right, Miss Marie?
Agree 100%.
All right. So it's all about the lifestyle. And it comes from building from one event to the other. Do not downplay the local events. They are the engine that drives the whole regional, national level. Right, Miss Marie? If you do not have an effective ground game, and I mean that, which is your local events, the regional events and the national events would not happen. Because the only way that people come to the regional national events is because the local events are working. Would you not agree?
Mm-hmm. That is the way it happens.
That's right. Period. And then the local events could be in your home. It doesn't have to be at a hotel. None of that. Okay. You could do Zoom meetings, you know, if you want. But eventually, Zoom meetings are going to have to lead to in-person, despite the virus. Okay. I mean, it's got to. There's just no way around it. All right. With that being said, guys, tomorrow's episode, guess what? We talked about this before. We talked about you get 95% of your income from three legs. But where do those three legs come from? Okay. You got to realize that 95% of your income is going to come from three to five businesses. And we talk about the one-third. Well, guess what? We're going to talk about that tomorrow. This is a critical episode or podcast tomorrow. You do not want to miss that because you need to know where your money's coming from. You need to know how to protect it. You need to know how to work with it. You need to know how to identify it. And you got to understand what's going to happen, how that could unfold. Would you not agree, Miss Marie?
Yep. And just to clarify, so tomorrow we're going to be talking about where that 95% of your income comes from. And then on Wednesday morning, we're going to be talking in more detail about that one-third.
That's right.
So you want to be sure to join us for the next two episodes.
That's right.
Absolutely. 11 a.m. Eastern time.
That's right.
Or if you can't join us live, of course, catch the recording after the fact.
On our website. On our YouTube channel or Facebook page. All right, Miss Marie. All right. Tomorrow, 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, as always, guys, on our Facebook page or YouTube channel, we will go live and covering that. Miss Marie, we forgot about one thing. I can't believe it. That's my fault. Four critical mistakes, guys. I made boo-boo, and I should have brought this up. I know better. Miss Marie will cuss me out afterwards, but that's okay. The point is that four critical mistakes. You can see the number there, fourcriticalmistakes.com. Four, criticalmistakes.com. Go there. Limited time offer. Only $15.95. One video, one audio, one ebook. If you're making any one of these four critical mistakes, you are undermining the very success that you're trying to put into place. And in other words, in layman terms, you are spinning your wheels and getting nowhere. Okay. Find out what these four critical mistakes are. Learn how to avoid them or overcome them. You'll be glad you did. And there's hundreds of dollars worth of free bonuses that come with your purchase. All right. With that being said, Miss Marie, we're done now. I'm going to hop off of here. We shall see you tomorrow. Thank you, guys. God bless. We shall see you guys tomorrow at the same bat channel, same bat time, right, Miss Maria? As far as I know. All right. Y'all take care. God bless. We'll see you tomorrow.
Thanks for listening to today's podcast. Download our podcast on SoundCloud, Spotify, iTunes, and other podcast platforms. Visit our website at www.themlmsolution.net for additional important information, show details, and past shows. Follow us on Parler, Rumble, Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube. Please hit the like button, the subscribe button, or the get notified button while visiting our other social media platforms.